This original poster from 1936 advertises Savage Sporting Arms and features the likeness of Roy Chapman Andrews in the Gobi Desert. The poster was broken in half, attached to an old board, and we fully restored it at Poster Fix. Welcome back to Poster Fix, the place you come to see the restoration of original vintage posters. This poster is an advertising standee, and it's split. It's mounted to board. An ad for Savage Sporting Arms with a beautiful image of Roy Chapman Andrews. This was meant to stand up in a gun store. We're going to remove this and take it off the board so that we can linen back it. I need to soak it in water. It's going to be put in this bath. And now the poster is immersed in this water bath. And while it's absorbing the water and loosening up, I'm going to stretch a screen with canvas so that we can mount this poster to it. The poster for Savage Sporting Arms. Yes, it's true. Roy Chapman Andrews is a real-life Indiana Jones of sorts. He explored China in the 1920s. Three expeditions, actually, including a visit to the Gobi Desert. And the image on this poster is from a photograph taken of him in the Gobi Desert, although this poster has had some enhancement done to it in that the background is a full painting, and the foreground of him is retouched to blend in with the background. So it's a sort of enhancement of the photograph done through either an illustrator or a dot etcher or both. Savage Arms is an American gunmaker based in Westfield, Massachusetts, with operations in Canada. Savage makes a variety of rimfire and centerfire rifles, as well as Stevens single-shot rifles and shotguns. The company today is best known for the Model 99 lever-action rifle, which is no longer in production, and the 300 Savage. Savage was a subsidiary of Vista Outdoor until 2019, when it was spun off. Savage Arms was founded in 1894 by Arthur Savage in Utica, New York. Within 20 years, they were producing rifles, handguns, and ammunition. Savage introduced the first hammerless lever-action rifle, the Model 1895, derived from Arthur Savage's Model 1892 rifle that he had designed for Colt in a failed bid for a U.S. Army rifle contract that instead was won by the Krag Jorgensen design. The Model 1895 won a New York National Guard contract, but the contract was canceled due to political controversy.
Well, this has been soaking all night, so I have a feeling it's probably soaked enough to know whether it can be removed. So let me take it out of the water and see if we can do this. Let's see now, will this come off? I seem to be having some luck here. It's coming right off, then. Oh, wonderful. Well, you never know sometimes. These posters can be stubborn. Let's see about this side. Am I going to have the same luck, or is it going to be...
According to company officials, the Canadian division of Savage Arms exports 97% of its rifles, mostly to the U.S. as of 1997. In an interview with a local newspaper reporter in 2019, a senior company official said that 200,000 to 300,000 guns per year are manufactured at Lakefield. The same official said roughly 85% of its output is exported to the United States, 5% is exported to other countries, and 10% is sold within Canada. Boy, we buy a lot of guns in the U.S.
I'm gonna let this poster dry for a little while I do other things. We've got a screen here. This is acid-free paper. And we're gonna mount this acid-free paper to this cotton canvas to mount the Savage Arms poster to. This is a beautiful cotton canvas. Very fine stitch and lightweight. It flattens out easily when it's unrolled. Put down the larger sheet first. I'll position it about there. Beautiful colors on this thing. I'm letting it absorb first layer of wheat paste, and I'm also spraying it with some distilled water to help it expand and stay wet. I'm putting the second coat of wheat paste. Now I feel like it's totally expanded and flat. Look this over. Before I put this piece on, I'm going to roll it out with the roller to push out the air pockets and make sure it's pressed up against the acid-free paper and fully stretched out and flat.
Roy Chapman Andrews, born in 1884 and died in 1960. And he was an American explorer, adventurer, and naturalist, who became the director of the American Museum of Natural History. He led a series of expeditions through the politically disturbed China of the early 20th century into the Gobi Desert and Mongolia. The expeditions made important discoveries and brought the first known fossil dinosaur eggs to the museum. Chapman's popular writing about his adventures made him famous. Andrews was born on January 26, 1884, in Beloit, Wisconsin. As a child, he explored forests, fields, and waters nearby, developing marksmanship skills. He taught himself taxidermy and used funds from this hobby to pay tuition to Beloit College. After graduating, Andrews applied for work at the American Museum of Natural History in New York City. He so much wanted to work there that after being told that there were no openings at his level, Andrews accepted a job as a janitor in the taxidermy department and began collecting specimens for the museum. During the next few years, he worked and studied simultaneously, earning a Master of Arts degree in mammalogy from Columbia University. Andrews joined the Explorers Club in New York during 1908, 4 years after its founding. From 1909 to 1910, Andrews sailed on the USS Albatross to the East Indies, collecting snakes and lizards and observing marine mammals. In 1913, he sailed aboard the schooner Adventurous with owner John Borden to the Arctic. They were hoping to obtain a bowhead whale specimen for the American Museum of Natural History. On this expedition, he filmed some of the best footage of seals ever seen, though did not succeed in acquiring a whale specimen. He married Yvette Borop in 1914. Andrews, along with Henry Fairfield Osborne, was a proponent of the out-of-Asia theory of humanity's origins and led several expeditions to Asia from 1922 to 1928, known as the Central Asiatic Expeditions, to search for the earliest human remains in Asia. The expeditions did not find human remains. However, Andrews and his team made many other finds, including dinosaur bones and fossil mammals, and the first nests full of dinosaur eggs ever discovered. Andrews' account of these expeditions can be found in his book, The New Conquest of Central Asia. In 1927, the Boy Scouts of America made Roy Chapman Andrews an honorary scout, a new category of scout created that same year. This distinction was given to American citizens whose achievements in outdoor activity, exploration, and worthwhile adventure are of such an exceptional character as to capture the imagination of boys. Well, we're going to let this poster dry on the screen for a couple of days, and then we're going to go into it and restore it, touch it up. And after that, we're going to trim it down. You won't want to miss what it looks like when it's done, so don't go away. It's at this time I want to remind you that if you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, get in touch with me. Send me an email, or you can come here in person. If you want to come here in person, you need to set up an appointment so that I can send you a security pass and a parking pass if you're going to drive your own car. Otherwise, you can do it through email and you can ship your posters to me through UPS. Tell me something about your posters in your email. Tell me their size, tell me their condition, and send me photos of them, and I'll get back to you with a price and recommendations for restoration. Either way, I look forward to seeing your posters.
Hello, are you curious?
Yes.
Andrews was president of the Explorers Club from 1931 to 1934. In 1934, he became the director of the Natural History Museum. In his 1935 book, The Business of Exploring, he wrote, "I was born to be an explorer. There was never any decision to make. I couldn't do anything else and be happy." In 1942, Andrews retired to North Colebrook, Connecticut. He and Wilhelmina lived on a country estate of 160 acres, Ponda Woods. He wrote most of his autobiographical books of life and adventures here. Around 1958, Andrews moved to Carmel Valley, California. He died on March 11, 1960, of heart failure at Peninsula Community Hospital in Carmel, California. He is buried in Oakwood Cemetery in his hometown of Beloit.
Thank you.
Well, that about wraps it up for today's edition of Poster Fix. I look forward to seeing your posters, because at Poster Fix, we love to bring your vintage posters back to life.